depends on the horse, but you know, it's, I'll let the boss man call that.
Yep.
Jack, after the hard brace, I mean, were you surprised that he, is he doing surprisingly well after that kind of a run?
He came, not really, because he came out the Bob Lewis and the Santa Anita Derby in the same situation. It was just as if he never had a race. So it's so far so good.
That's great.
What has impressed you the most about this horse in these races leading up to the point where you are here now in Baltimore?
It's just the way he takes it on when we ship him. Obviously, when we shipped him into Kentucky, he did as if he'd stabled his whole life career there. He came out the race as if he never ran. He shipped there, he's went on the track fantastic this morning, and it's just, wow, this is... If we were to, six after we won the Santa Anita Derby, got a pen out and wrote down what we would like to see, this would be, he's shown us it.
You keep saying as if he never ran. You guys got Triple Crown in mind?
Yeah, we never want to get too ahead of ourselves, and obviously when you win the Kentucky Derby, I'm sure if you go back and ask all the previous Kentucky Derby connections, it's always in the back of your mind, but you never see it. We'll take each day as it comes and day by day, and it's in the back of our mind somewhere, but you know, we just keep monitoring and see how he comes along.
Jackie, you talk about the name for those of us who are familiar with how he got his name.
How he got his name was, well, the owners were sitting on the couch one night and they were eating cookies, and it was like, do you want another cookie? It was, I'll have another. And I suppose it just, wow, that's a catchy phrase. Okay. And sure enough, I'll have another.
And where were the owners? In California?
California, yeah.
Okay. What, do you know the town? And
I don't know, sorry.
Okay. And where are you from, Jack?
Durham, England.
Oh, you're from Durham?
Yeah.
Okay, okay. Yeah.